This is Colin Daniel from riffninja.com. I'm going to teach you a song. What song am I going to teach you? A simple song. Something you can pick up fairly quickly. Actuality, some of these simple songs are, well, they're not so simple. But we can simplify it to a point where if you're a beginner, you should be able to pick up on it. Now, this is All Along the Watchtower by Jimi Hendrix, the Jimi Hendrix version. It could be in several different keys depending on what version you listen to. And there's also the Bob Dylan, which is Bob Dylan wrote the song. So, and this is what happens. There's three chords in it. The key I've learned to play it in is the key of B minor, but it doesn't start on a B minor. It starts on an A. I use bar chords. You could use an open chord like an A like this. I use an A here. Then I move it up two frets, and I take my second finger off, and that becomes B minor. Then I have to go back down. That's A again. Pass through the A to the G. That's G major. Back up. It just keeps repeating that. Same here. You could play A major, B minor, A major, G major. Although I find this progression much more friendly to my scale. In the end, when you get better, you'll want to put some fills in between that, and you'd be better off playing the sixth string B minor up here at the seventh fret. And now the timing for it, it's pretty easy. It starts on an A. If you count it in, it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and there's a lot of different tracks on the Jimi song, and I've heard a lot of other people play it, interpret it, and so my interpretation of it is affected by all of that. Don't take it as written in stone, like exactly like Jimi, but these are definitely the chords. A major, B minor, A major, G major, and sometimes Jimi played it and one semitone higher. And if that's the case, then all the chords are moved up one semitone. Could also be that he was tuned to E flat. In that case, what I'm playing for you would work in C because we're tuned down a semitone. But that's not as much of a concern as just getting these chord changes down, because they're easy enough to move around. You can cheat. You can play power chords in here too. You know, just the 1 and the 5. From riffninja.com, and have yourself a good one. Work on those chords so you get them down real good and smooth. That's what you need to do. They're applied in a lot of other songs. Okay, peace out for now. See you later.